is as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being translated, God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from his sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. In that little bit of text in Matthew, you can see a lot of unanswered questions. And a lot of opportunities where you say, I don't believe it. And Joseph, one of the key phrases there, was a just man. He did what was right in the eyes of God. And he knew the voice of God. And he understood when he was confronted with conversation. And he believed and he followed through with obedience. But I think of, would you believe it? I think of these prophecies. You have the prophecy there in verse 23 from Isaiah. 700 years before Jesus was born, Isaiah made that prophecy. Would you have believed Isaiah if you lived in that day? Oh yeah, Isaiah, that's it. There's going to be a Messiah. Okay? And then in Jeremiah 31:31, the verse says, Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Can you imagine the questions are put into people's mind in the days of Jeremiah? Oh, sure. Jeremiah and Micah and Isaiah all lived around the same time frame, and they had these prophecies of the coming Messiah. And Micah gave the prophecy in chapter 5, verse 2, that Jesus, that this, Now, but you, Bethlehem, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be the ruler in Israel. To Micah, the prophet, that he would be born in Bethlehem. Can you hear the critics and the skeptics? Oh, this is a lot of prophecy. This is a lot of hot air. This is a lot of news that we can't hardly believe. Then you move into the times of the New Testament when the angels made their appearances to Mary. When Mary received the news from the angel, I'm sure it was overwhelming. She accepted it as she was one who was highly favored. And she said, Nevertheless, according to thy will. And she was willing to carry the Son of God, knowing fully that it was from God. Not everyone would believe that. In their culture, she would have been ridiculed, she would have been ostracized and not believed. But Joseph had the appearance from an angel, and he believed. And he applied the message given to him. And he was willing to accept Mary, even though he knew that there would be problems and there would be rejection and people wouldn't agree with what he did. But these messages, would we believe it? Probably not. I know I'll speak for me. If you were to tell me, if Mary were to come to me and say, I am carrying the Son of God, I am expecting a child, and tell us all the details of that, and I would be like, No, that's not how that works. And then we would be resisting what God has purposed and planned. And then lastly, you think of this gift that he provided of Jesus. Would you believe it? The question was asked to Martha at the resurrection of Lazarus before he was resurrected from the dead. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he die, yet shall he live. Do you believe this? If you don't believe that, you'll not have eternal life. You have to believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, as was read in the Advent reading, or you will live in darkness. And when you live in darkness, you are absent from the light and the truth, who is Jesus, and you will have a life without purpose and meaning and fulfillment. And it doesn't get any better than that when this life is done. It gets worse. But it can all be changed when we receive what God has given us, His gift of eternal life, His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have everlasting life. The bottom line question, would you believe it, that Jesus died on the cross for your sins? Would you believe it that He had that in His plan before you were ever even thought of? And He knew all this was going to happen in life, and He still has a purpose and a program, and He's worthy of our trust. So if you believe it, it's a life changer. It's a hope that never disappoints. I trust that if you don't know the Lord Jesus as your Savior and you never ask Him to forgive you and to give you the gift of eternal life, that you do that this day for this Christmas season, because that's how you can have eternal life. Let's have a word of prayer, and we'll have a special from Alex and Perry. Father, thank you for life. Thank you for love. Thank you for Jesus, that was willing to go to the cross and pay the price for our sin. And if there's anyone in this auditorium or under the sound of my voice that don't know you as Lord and Savior, may they take a moment and ask you in their heart to forgive their sins and to give them the gift of eternal life. And Father, you said whoever would ask that you would receive, and that you would give them eternal life and place them in your family, a promised future and a blessed hope. And these things we thank you for. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The scriptures record the birth of Christ. And I'll read verses 1 to 6, and we'll sing the verse of a little town of Bethlehem. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. This taxing first took place when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. So all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his espoused wife, who was great with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. Let's sing a verse of O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
riding out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And behold, the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid. Then the angel of the Lord said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you that you will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." Let's sing Silent Night, Holy Night. Oh, I skipped. Shepherd, while shepherds watch their flocks by night. One verse. Sorry.
Thank you.
To the world, first and last.